Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the first example on multi-loop circuits. We have a figure where two batteries are ideal. The word ideal means that there is no internal resistance of these batteries. One of them is 24 volts. The other one, it's EMF, we don't know. What must be the EMF E of this second battery if the current in the 7 ohm resistor is 1.5 ampere? So this current, I3, I call it 1.5 ampere, okay? And let me assume the current here is called I1, okay? And here at this junction, here I have I2, okay? So I have I1 is unknown, I2 is unknown, and I3 is given to be 1.5 ampere, okay? We want to know how much is E. EMF of the second battery. Okay, so from our knowledge of Kirchhoff's laws and the loop rule, I'll apply the loop rule on this loop. I start from here, okay, go for this large loop. Let me call it loop one. Okay, so this is loop one. For loop one, what do I notice? If I start from here, we will experience, you see the current I1 is going up, okay? So the current I1 is moving this way. This is my assumption, okay? It is just an assumption, and I'll solve the problem accordingly. So I1 is moving this way, and I know that passing through a resistor with the current, you will experience a potential drop. So there will be potential drop. How much is the potential drop? It is minus I1 multiplied by 3. So for the resistor, we look at the direction of the current. Now we are moving with the direction of the current across the resistor. So there will be potential drop. Potential drop equals IR. So it is minus I1 multiplied by R, which is 3 ohm. Then for the battery, I go from the minus side or minus terminal to the positive terminal. So I'll experience a potential increase. How much is that potential increase? It is E of that battery, which is 24 volts, okay? As I go there is nothing, okay, until I reach the 7 ohm with the same direction of the current. So the current I3 is going this way, okay? And I am going through I3 across the resistor 7 ohm with the same direction of the current, meaning there will be potential drop. How much is that potential drop? It is minus I3, which is 1.5 ampere, multiplied by this resistance, which is 7 ohm. All of this is equal to 0 because I complete the loop. So I have this resistor, battery, I go all the way, resistor, I come back to the initial point, okay? If you plug in the numbers, you will get that I1 equals, from here I1 is unknown, I3 is given to be 1.5 ampere. Plugging in the numbers, I1 will be equal to 4.5 amperes. 4.5 amperes, okay? So here I have 4.5 amperes, 4.5 amperes, and at this junction, what happens? I have I3 going this way, and I2 going the other way. So I3 is 1.5, how much should be I2? Yes, I2, it's very clear that I1, so from the junction, let me call this junction A. So at junction A, we know that I1 will distribute to I2 plus I3. So from here we can write that I2 equals I1 minus I3. And this will be 4.5 minus 1.5. This will give us 3 amperes, okay? So this I2 equals 3 amperes. 3 amperes. Okay, now I am ready to find how much is the EMF of the second battery. So we'll apply the loop rule on another loop. Let me choose another loop. So I am done with loop number one. I'll choose another small loop in order to find what is E of the second EMF. Okay, I might choose this loop. Okay, I go from here to there. Let me call this loop two. Okay, so loop two. First of all, I'll experience potential drop minus I1 multiplied by 3 plus 24. Okay, then minus E, because I am coming from the positive terminal to the negative terminal of the EMF. So this will be potential drop. In addition to moving across this 2-ohm resistor in the same direction of the current, so there will be also potential drop. How much is that potential drop? This will be minus I2 multiplied by 2 ohms. All of this is equal to 0. Okay, we know I3 is I1. Sorry, from where I brought I3? Because here I1 is moving, so I1 multiplied by 3. Okay, plus 24 minus E, then I have minus I2 multiplied by 2. Sorry for that mistake. So this is 4.5 amperes. And I2 is 3 amperes. If you plug in the numbers, we will get that E equals 4.5 volts. Okay? Also, there is no harm if you decide to use the loop number 3. You can choose loop number 3 like this. Let us do it. You will get the same. You will get the same answer. Okay, another method. We are done. But let us another method. We can use loop number 3. For loop number 3, we have a potential increase, and that is I2 multiplied by 2. Then potential increase also, which is that E, the unknown EMF. Then potential drop, which is I3 multiplied by 7. All of this is equal to 0. I2 is 3 amperes, and I3 is given to be 1.5 amperes. So here we have 6 plus E minus 1.5 multiplied by 7. All of this is equal to 0. So we'll end up with E equals 10.5 minus 6, which is 4.5 volts. Okay, you notice that we got the same answer by applying the Kirchhoff law for loop 3, and the same answer for loop number 2. Thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the second example on multi-loop circuits. For the circuit shown in the figure, what is the current in the upper 20-ohm resistor? Let us give labeling for the resistors. I have R1 20 ohm, R2 10 ohms, R3 20, R4 15, R5 5, and R6 10 ohms, and the EMF, the battery has 45 volts. Okay? He is asking about how much current is passing through R1, okay, which is the upper 20 ohm resistor. Okay, first of all, would like to find the equivalent circuit for this large circuit. It is very clear that R1, R2, R3 are connected in parallel. Okay, so their equivalent resistance will be R1, 2, 3. Okay, so I can replace R1, R2, R3 with their equivalent resistance, which is R1, 2, 3. Okay, then R1, 2, 3 is connected in series with R4, with R5, with R6. Okay, and this is the circuit. So R1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all of them can be replaced with their equivalent, which is R1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so what is R1, 2, 3? We know for R1, R1, and R2, R3 are connected in parallel, are in parallel. So to find their equivalent, we know that 1 over R1, 2, 3 equals 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. Okay, so this will be equal to 1 over 20 plus 1 over 10 plus 1 over 20. So this can be solved. Okay, here we'll have 20. So this will be 1 plus 2 plus 1, and this will be 4 divided by 20. That is 1 over R1, 2, 3. To find R1, 2, 3, it will be the inverse of this, which is 20 divided by 4, and this will give us 5 ohms. Okay? So this R1, 2, 3 is 5 ohms. Okay? 5 ohms connected in series with 15, 5, and 10 ohms. Okay? So to find R1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be just the summation of all of them. It will be R1, 2, 3 plus R4 plus R5 plus R6. And this will give us 5 ohms plus R4, 15, plus R5, which is 5, plus 10. And the answer for this, here we have 20 plus 15. This will be 35 ohms, okay? So, as if we have this battery connected to 35 ohms, okay? Now, we can calculate how much is I equivalent, the current which is coming from this battery. It's very trivial to say that I equivalent equals what? Equals this 45 volts divided by the 35 ohm. Okay, so it will be 45 divided by 35 ohms. How did I know that? I simply applied the Kirchhoff loop rule here in this direction. So I can simplify it for you because some students might not be able to get it. Here we have potential increase 45 minus I equivalent multiplied by 35. All of this is equal to zero. So from here we'll find that I equivalent equals 45 divided by 35, and this will give us 1.286 amperes. This is the equivalent, this is the equivalent current. I am done. Now, he wants to find how much is the current going through the 20 ohm resistor, R1. Okay? So we know I equivalent, which is 1.286, is coming out of the battery, so it will pass through R1, 2, 3. This is I equivalent, the same current, 1.286. It will pass through R4, it will pass through R5, it will pass through R6. Okay, so the current passing through all of these is I equivalent, 1.286. Okay, so I'll solve the problem with in two different ways. Okay, the first way, I know that I equivalent passing through this, I equivalent, okay, and it is the one which is coming here, I equivalent. It is the current moving here, 1.286. Okay, but when it comes to this junction, it will distribute okay, on R1, R2, and R3. But this I equivalent is passing through R1, 2, 3. The first way, first method to find I1, so to find I1, method 1. First method, I use the loop rule. So I start from a certain point. Let me start from here, from this point, like this, from the battery. Okay, I go there in R1, then I go down to R4, R5, R6, and I come here. I am moving in this direction. Okay, and I call this loop 1. Okay, I apply loop 1, use loop rule. For the loop rule, let me start from the battery. I have potential increase of 45. Then the current, this is the main current, is moving this way. So the current I1 is moving this way, I1. Okay, so there will be potential drop. So this will be minus I1 multiplied by the 20 ohm. Okay, so this is 20 ohm. Then still we have minus again I equivalent multiplied by R4, minus I equivalent multiplied by R5, minus I equivalent multiplied by R6. So this will be I equivalent multiplied by 15 plus 5 plus 10. Okay, and all of this is equal to 0 because I reach to the point where I have started. Okay, so I equivalent, we know it. Okay, so this will be 45 minus 20 I1 minus 15 plus 5, 20 plus, so this will be 30 multiplied by I equivalent, which is 1.286. All of this is equal to 0. From here, we will get that I1 equals 0.321 amperes. This is one method to find I1. Method number two to find I1. I use that I equivalent, which is 1.286, is passing through R123, which is equivalent for 123. Okay, so we can find what is V123 equals V1 equals V2 equals V3. Why? Because they are connected in parallel. So parallel connection, we will have the same potential across these three resistors. Okay, so what is V123? It is I123 multiplied by R123. Okay, and this will be the same as V1. Okay, so we can also, knowing that V1 is nothing but I1 multiplied by R1. Okay, what is I123? It is the I equivalent. So this is 1.286 multiplied by, what is the equivalent R123? It is 5, okay, equals I1, which we don't know, R1, which is 20. So I'll end up with I1, the current passing through R1 there, I1 equals 1.286 multiplied by 5 divided by 20, and this will give us the current, which is 0.321. It is the same answer. Okay, I hope with this, my son, you know different ways to tackle these problems and find the required unknowns. Thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the last example on multi-loop circuits. in the figure, which might look very complicated, but it is not the case, all the resistors have a resistance of 4 ohm. So all these resistors are identical and they have 4 ohm resistance, and all batteries are ideal. All of these batteries are ideal batteries, no internal resistance, and they have an EMF of 4 volts. What is the current through the resistance R? This resistance here, we want to know how much is the current passing through it, okay? So to answer this problem, you know, it has many, many, many loops, and there are many currents passing through. So the best way to answer this problem is to choose the simplest loop in order to apply the Kirchhoff loop rule, okay? So I want to draw a certain loop, okay? But I have to choose it very smart way, okay? Let me give you a wrong choice. Wrong choice of a loop, if you go here, okay, and you go there, for example, and come back this way. Is it easy to apply Kirchhoff rule on this loop? Here I have certain current, and let us assume that the current is in this direction. This is I, okay? Of course, here we have different current passing through this resistance. There is another third different current here. So you will end up with three unknown currents, okay? Three unknown currents in one problem, meaning that this is a wrong choice and you cannot answer the problem. So let me call this R2 and the current through it is I2. This is, I call it R3, and the current through it is I3. You know this problem? I'll end up with minus IR, okay? Minus I2R, because all of them are equivalent, same R. Minus I3R, all of this is equal to zero. Very difficult, very complicated. You cannot answer. Because you don't know this current, you don't know this current, and this is the required current. So what is the smartest way? Smartest way is to avoid passing through resistors. Okay, so choose a loop avoiding resistors. Because resistors means that you need to know the current passing through that resistor, okay? So I'll design, this was a quick choice and it is wrong. It is not the best way to do it. So I have to go through this resistor in order to find the current passing through it, only this resistor, okay? So I go this way, okay, this way. Of course, the current, I have to assume that the current is in this direction. And afterwards, we will know whether this choice of the current is correct or wrong, okay? Then, going to the left, I'll find this resistor. Going up, I'll find that resistor. So the best choice is to go this way, okay? Then, I can go through battery. No problem to go through a battery. Okay, then I go this way until here I have a battery only, okay? So I can go this direction, okay? Then, I continue going here. This is also a battery. Here also, battery. Then, finally, I will reach to the initial point. You notice this? I passed through one resistor only, and the rest, I have what? Batteries, EMF, okay? So, I have proposed or suggested that the current is moving up, so there will be potential drop, and this is the direction of my loop. Huh? So the loop is going this way, okay? So I start with this minus IR, okay? Then battery from negative to positive, so this will be plus E, okay? Then I go through a battery from positive to negative, so this will be minus E. Okay, I am done with that one. Then another minus E. Okay, then another minus E. Okay, going through a battery from positive to negative will give you minus E or potential drop. Okay, until you reach the original point, which is zero. So plus E will cancel with that minus E, and we are left with minus I R equals 2E. Okay, and from here we can find that I will be minus 2E divided by R. Okay, and this will be minus 2 multiplied by E, which is 4 volts, divided by the resistance, which is 4 ohms. So 4 will cancel with 4. So this will be minus 2 amperes. So the current I has a magnitude of 2 amperes. What is its direction? What is its direction? This minus sign tells us that the chosen direction was not correct. Okay? The correct direction of the current is down. Okay? The current through R is downward. Okay? So it turns out to be a very simple problem if you properly choose the smartest loop. So we choose a loop avoiding resistors except the resistor of interest. This resistor of interest, which we want to find what is the current passing through it. Thank you.